Welcome back, baseball fans, to the All-Star Game selection show for the 2021 season. Players from 1969 to 72. We're going to start with the American League, go to the National League. We have 16 hitters, 9 pitchers. I'll take a break in between just to reset everything. And we'll just get right into it. We have the stats at the All-Star break right here, and that makes it convenient to kind of go down, as that's what I kind of looked at as a guiding point here. And also the number of representatives of how good the team was. So the first player to go to the All-Star game, the only guy hitting 400, Mr. Rod Carew, member of the Minnesota Twins, is the All-Star game second baseman. Congratulations, Rod Carew. Gonna plug him in to I'm gonna zoom this, make it a little bit bigger so you can see it better. There we go. And lo and behold, this was the All-Stars of last year, which had some 1980 players in it as well. And look at that, Rod Carew was the All-Star starter last year. And he hits better this year than he did last year. He's taking the same spot on the roster for the American League. Congratulations, Rod Carew. Whoops. Next, the next player to be chosen for the American League, representing the California Angels, Alex Johnson. He was famously snubbed last year, and not so this year, and good for him. He has been going to be the DH. Or actually, he just might be the utility guy. He'll take Harold Bain's spot from last year. Congratulations, Alex Johnson. In your second year of eligibility, you're in the All-Star game. Next up, you'll notice that John Ellis got snubbed. Had hitting 369 for the Seattle, and he's not going to the All-Star game. Mariner fans are apoplectic, but there is quite a wealth of talent behind the plate in the American League, and Ellis unfortunately has to wait his turn. Also, John Jeter does not go to the All-Star game, hitting 368. They noted the homer RBI total was low. Okay. The next All-Star is Bobby Mercer from the New York Yankees. We saw him just before the All-Star break. Helped the Yankees win a game in extra innings. We consider him to be high up on the MVP list, the American League. Has a lot of RBIs. Great year for Bobby. He'll be your starting center fielder. And look at that. He was in center field last year. He hit 357 with 35 hits. This year, 365 with 46 hits. Congratulations, Bobby, for getting back to the big game. We'll keep doing that. All right, next up, a nice little pick here. Tommy Harper is going to the All-Star game, folks. Tommy Harper, versatile Tommy from the Milwaukee Brewers. He could play third base, left field, second base. Versatility in All-Star game is very handsome. He will take up a utility spot. Let's plug old Tommy in here. His 1970 card, he had 31 home runs. And we'll take Terry Francona's spot. One of those 1980s players I was telling you about. Congratulations to Tommy Harper, also 16 stolen bases. One of the leaders in the American League. All right, we have five guys or four guys in the All-Star game. And the next guy on the list, Bobby Grich, a rookie for the Orioles. Surprise, he was not even on the Oriole team that won the World Series last year. The Oriole offense has been disappointing this year, but not Bobby Grich. Hitting 345 and currently looking like the American League Rookie of the Year. His defense at short's not too good, but we have a capable backup for him. And yes, he will replace Rico Petrocelli, who's having kind of a down year. Petrocelli's not going to the All-Star game this year. Sorry about that, Boston. Congratulations, Bobby Grich and the Orioles. Okay, we got five players in. Next up, another rookie from the class of 72. From the young and up-and-coming Kansas City Royals, John Mayberry. John Mayberry hitting 343. His homer total's low, but he's carrying the young Royals this year. And John will be plugged in at first base, replacing Don Mattingly from the 80s portion of this roster sheet. Congratulations, John Mayberry. Nice transaction. He came from Houston Astros. He didn't do very well there. And the Royals made a deal for him, and he blossomed in Kansas City. We have six players selected thus far. Next up for the American League, sorry Ed Stroud, you got snubbed. You were mostly a platoon player, as was Gary Sutherland. But nice little player here, coming off his 68 performance. We have Jim Northrup having a nice 1969 for the Detroit Tigers, two of their representatives. Jim Northrup going to the All-Star game for the Tigers. And he'll be plugged into an outfield spot. He can take Frank Robinson's spot because he's not going this year. Actually, we'll put him in right field because Reggie's not going either. Spoiler alert. Congratulations, Jim Northrup. He's going to the All-Star game. Okay. Next up, for the American League, Mac Jones gets snubbed. And here comes another Yankee. A very capable Yankee. The rivalry of catchers in the American League East begins in this All-Star game. Thurman Munson is going to the All-Star game. He had a big series against the Orioles just before the All-Star break. Brings a -4 arm. That's one of the things that you don't see in the stats. So that -4 arm is just ridiculous for an All-Star game. Munson will replace Gary Carter, another 80s player. And the second Yankee thus far in the All-Star game. Congratulations, Thurman Munson. Carl Taylor gets snubbed. Merv Rettman, Horace Clark gets snubbed. Here is a guy who didn't get snubbed. Interesting stats he has. And actually kind of a Lifetime Achievement Award as well. Harmon Killebrew hasn't been to an All-Star game recently, but he has 11 dingers, even though he has just 17 RBIs. We like the fact that he can play first and third in DH. So Harmon Killebrew, we won't be starting, but he'll take a roster spot. We currently have him as corner man. He can take Mike Epstein's spot. Congratulations, Harmon Killebrew, the second twin thus far named to the All-Star game. Okay, next up, L'Orange Grand. Last time we saw Rusty Staub, he hit a game-ending homer against the Ohio players to put the Expos within a game and a half of first place. Congratulations, break it up for Rusty. Rusty freaking Staub going to the All-Star game, folks. And I think we got him starting in right field, if I'm not mistaken. Let's check it out. Oh, we have Northrop over there, don't we? Somebody else is going to be playing left field. We'll give him Lescano's spot. Congratulations, Rusty Staub, the Expo representative. Next up, Ray Fosse is not going to the All-Star game with a 319 average. Just like John Ellis, two outstanding hitting catchers, snubbed. Hard to believe. Norm Cash, he was going to go, but Jim Northrop took his spot. Because another Tigers also clogging up the Detroit pipeline. Now the White Sox, they get on the board with their only player. It's going to be Louis Aparicio. He had been to some All-Star games in previous years, not last year. And he will be the defensive replacement for Bobby Grich. So, Louis Aparicio will be considered a middleman, replacing Dick Schofield. Congratulations, Louis Aparicio. Whoops, did that wrong. Try again. Congratulations, Louis Aparicio and the Chicago White Sox. You are going to the All-Star game. All right. We are getting down close to the pitchers. The next representative, and finally, the first Boston player named, the team with the number one seed in the American League, the Boston Red Sox. It's been kind of a down year with the offense, but Yastrzemski, of course, is going to the All-Star game leading the Red Sox. Carl could play first or the outfield. And we have him in left field, taking Frank Robinson's spot. Congratulations, Carl Yastrzemski and the Red Sox. Their first representative in the All-Star game. Next up, Larry Heisel gets skipped. Nice year for him. Jim Fregosi at shortstop. A nice year, but we saw the performances at shortstop by Grich and Aparicio. Here we go, folks. Look at this catcher. And you would, it's just a lot of great catching in the American League. And Gene Tennis, the first Oakland A player invited to the All-Star game. Gene Tennis, his 1970 card, which is probably his best card. He is going to be, they have to be really creative here. He's going to take the Tony Pena spot. Congratulations, Gene Tennis. Next up for the American League, no Sandy Alomar, no Chuck Hinton. The third catcher. That's right. I could not resist, folks. And of course, it's Carlton Fisk joining Thurman Munson and Gene Tennis, snubbing Ray Fosse and John Ellis. That's five catchers hitting close to 300 or more with a bazillion home runs. When do you see that? Carlton Fisk. Now we have to plug him into a utility spot. Or a DH spot because you just have too many catchers. On my sheet, I have him as utility player. Where Alex Johnson was, but Alex Johnson should be a DH. One of these guys is not playing. Oh, Killebrew has to play. No, that's for somebody else. Let's see, where are we plugging this guy in at? Oh, we'll just put Fisk, move Tommy Harper to the outfield. And make the utility guy Fisk. So we'll just use Willie Horton's roster spot, no big deal, from last year, and use Fisk this year. Carlton Fisk, a gridlock of catchers for the American League. I guess one will be a DH. Haven't named the starting lineup yet, so there's that. The second Red Sox player, Carlton Fisk. All right, we are down to one. Two more hitters before we get to the pitching. Tony Oliva gets snubbed. You know why? He had 7 homers in the opening series against Oakland and only 2 more after that. He kind of really tailed off. Here's your third Yankee player, as they had the best record in baseball before the series before the All-Star break, and they slid out of first momentarily. But it's Greg Nettles. Actually, Greg Nettles was with Cleveland during this era, but the Yankees made that trade for him. 9 homers, 22 RBIs. We have Greg Nettles and Killebrew eligible to play third base. He could take Cesar Tovar's spot from last year. Congratulations. Greg Nettles, the third Yankee hitter in the All-Star game. The Yankees, if you are hitting .300 as a team. And the 16th hitter, the next guy, we have to scroll down a little bit because the batting average starts to dip. And his stats really aren't incredible. This is another one of those Lifetime Achievement Award kind of things. You really got to scroll down. But there he is. Frank Howard, your 2020 Most Valuable Player, has been invited back. Because the All-Star game in 1969 was played in Washington, home of the Washington Senators. So we're going to put the All-Star game in Texas this year, home of the Texas Rangers. So there was Frank at the All-Star game last year with 10 homers and 28 RBI. This year, 8 homers, 20 RBI. So these are the 16 hitters of the American League: Munson, Mayberry, Carew, Nettles, Gritch, Yastrzemski, Mercer, Northrop, Howard, Tennis, Killebrew, Aparicio, Staub, Fisk, Harper, and Alex Johnson. Now, let's get to the American League pitchers. Oh, this is a fun list, too. The American League pitchers. 9 of them. At the top of the list, this gentleman, Catfish Hunter. The ace, actually he's the number 2 starter. He's just having such a much better year than Vita Blue. 6-2, .178 ERA. Catfish Hunter will probably start in the All-Star game for the American League. He may as well take Vita Blue's spot. Congratulations, Catfish Hunter. American League. And that is the second and final Oakland player in the All-Star game. The next pitcher, here he is, folks. Number 3 starter for Detroit, Joe Coleman. Clearly shining over Mickey Lolich and Denny McClain in the rotation. He is 6-1 with a .181 ERA. That's right, folks. Joe Coleman. Keeping the Tigers' season alive. Even with a losing record, the Tigers can still win this division. And they have Joe Coleman to thank for that. So Joe Coleman, we'll just plug him in a Denny McClain spot from last year. Denny's not going. Congratulations, Joe Coleman, the second and final Tiger invited to the All-Star game. Next, Roger Maret was skipped. He was skipped because he only had 4 wins and 44 innings, even though he had a .184 ERA. And for some reason, Red Sox pitchers get snubbed, and that draws the ire. The ire, I tell you. Roger Maret was skipped. And instead, they went with the more accomplished Bill Singer, acquired in the offseason from the Dodgers for Andy Messersmith. And then Singer has righted the Angels organization where Nolan Ryan has faltered. Bill Singer, I believe he was in the All-Star game last year for the Dodgers. Or was he not? Maybe the year before that. I don't see Singer over here. So Bill Singer, we'll put him into, oddly enough, Nolan Ryan's spot for the moment. Congratulations, Bill Singer, the second and final Angel player in the All-Star game. Next, Rudy May was passed, only 2 wins. Acquired in a blockbuster trade in the offseason that helped both teams, Minnesota and Portland, Burt Blyleven. We'll get to Portland later in this video. But Bert Blyleven returns to Minnesota to begin his career with his 80s cards were with Portland, but his beginning of his career with Minnesota is back. So that's great news for Twins. Just getting started on a long career in Minnesota. He'll probably play between 8 and 12 years here before we start moving him around his migration through baseball. And for the Twins, the surprising Twins get three representatives, tying the Yankees for the most representatives in the American League, the Minnesota Twins. He can take Jim Rooker's spot, because Rooker's not going this year. Congratulations, Bert Blyleven and the Minnesota Twins and their three representatives. Next up, Fritz Peterson gets ignored. Mike Paul and Doyle Alexander and Louis Tiant and Sonny Siebert both get ignored with Roger Maret. And the problem with the Boston pitchers, four wins. We need to see 5, 6, or 7 wins. That's the guys who are usually getting these starting spots. Such as the next guy, Don Wilson, guiding the Ohio players into first place, their lone representative. Don Wilson goes to his first All-Star game. He will take Ken Tatum's spot. Congratulations to the lone Ohio... Whoops, don't do that. Don Wilson, the lone representative for the Ohio players. All right. Only 4 more spots left for the All-Star game. And if you've been following these teams, we got a fourth place. We have actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 4 more pitching spots left, but teams in the bottom. And it's all relievers. 4 relievers. So going down the list, you have to scroll down a little bit. Ken Tatum did not go to the All-Star game. Stunningly, the Angels are apoplectic. How can you not let Ken Tatum make his third consecutive All-Star game? 18 2/3 innings, a 48-cent ERA, and 6 saves. Well, that's the problem. There's just not enough roster spots to go around. The Angels already have Bill Singer and Alex Johnson's leads the league, American League in hits. So Ken Tatum gets the snub. Boy, that's sad, isn't it? Oh, well. But the Seattle Mariners lone representative for the All-Star game for the third and final year in a row, a fan favorite, this guy named Lou Marrone. The story of Lou Marrone is that he pitched 1 year and organized in the MLB in 1969 through 35 innings for the Pirates. Seattle acquired him in the expansion draft, and he has been nothing but lights out the entire time. He was in the All-Star game last year, right there, and he returns. Last year, he had 7 saves and a 96-cent ERA. This year, 6 saves and a $1.98 ERA. But Lou Marrone is coming back, a staple of the Seattle Mariners. Congratulations, Lou Marrone, one of the rare 3-time All-Stars who threw 35 innings in his entire career. That's the fun we have in the carryover league. All right. Next up, 3 pitchers left. And Dick Hall's not going for the Orioles because the ERA is a little high. Steve Mingori is going to represent the Cleveland Indians, who have had a rough year. But you see, Mingori took Ken Tatum's spot because his ERA is better than 0.48. It's 0.00. Steve Mingori has been untouchable this year for the Cleveland Indians. And the Indians still have a chance in the second half in the tournament, as they are just 3 games out of first. As a lefty reliever, he'll take Dave Righetti's spot. Congratulations, Steve Mingori and the Cleveland Indians. You get a guy in the All-Star game. All right, we're down to 2 more guys. 2 more pitchers. They have a lot of saves, and it's not Jack Aker. He got snubbed because the Yankees had too many guys. They had Mercer, Nettles, and Thurman Munson. Jack Aker lost two games, these two games, to the Orioles in the last series, even though he has a 71-cent ERA, so he gets skipped. But the Toronto Blue Jays putting up, they're fighting, folks. They've got the worst draw in this entire carryover league, being in the American League East without a farm system or with nothing to do but collect extra players. And Joe Grazenda was one of those extra players. You have to ignore the 5.11 ERA, folks, and just go with the seven saves because they need a guy. And actually, Grazenda is the best pitcher on the Toronto team. So Joe Grazenda will take Ken Sanders' spot. Congratulations, Joe Grazenda and the Toronto Blue Jays. And last, and not least, the final member in the bullpen is this gentleman right here, leading the American League in saves for the Kansas City Royals, and it is 84-cent ERA, Mo Drabowski. Let's hear it from Mo. Mo Drabowski will be the closer in the All-Star game for the American League. He's doing it for the Kansas City Royals, their second representative joining John Mayberry. And that does it for the American League. The 25 players for the American League. We'll compare the statistics from last year's team at the end of the video. I'm going to pause a moment for station identification, and we will get to the National League All-Stars.
This is the Shrimp Trawler video channel.
Este es el canal de videos de camaroneros.
Okay, we're back with the National League. Starters and reserves, the All-Star game. Same format, we'll start with the hitters, then get to the pitchers. National League. First off, we have a snub to start us off. Jim Lytle, leading the National League with a .382 batting average. Not invited because he plays for the Arizona Diamondbacks. And Diamondback fans, they weren't exactly quiet about that. They stormed four-year carryover league headquarters, pelted the windows with undesirables, and are just furious. But Jim Lytle, the reasoning is he does not have 100 at-bats, and he is a platoon player. And we try and not let these guys squeak in and let the everyday guys take their spots. So sorry, Jim Lytle, it's not your year. Which leads us to the second guy on the list. Ken Singleton, a snub! Back-to-back snubs for the National League. Kenny Singleton, his 1970 card for the Mets, first time into the league. And 376, he's been holding the Mets, but the Mets have been doing that much this year compared to the other National League teams, and so Kenny gets under 100 at-bats. He gets snubbed. Okay, well, it's about time we put a guy in the All-Star game, folks. And we're going to start right here. A player from, you're going to hear this pretty often, a player from the Big Red Machine, the Cincinnati Reds. Obviously, the best team in this league. Bobby Tolan is going to the All-Star game, starting in center field for the National League. Congratulations, Bobby Tolan. He will replace Willie Davis, a Dodger who started last year. Congratulations, Bobby Tolan and the Cincinnati Reds. Next up for the National League, we're going to keep it going with Manny Mota. Or like they said in Airplane, batting for Pedro Bourbon, Manny Mota. The heart and soul best player on the Florida Marlins. He will actually play a nice chunk of his career with the Marlin team. We're going to let those Dodger pinch hitting years in the mid to late 70s continue into Florida. Mota has a reserve outfield spot. We'll give him Jeff Stone's spot from last year. How about that? Congratulations, Manny Mota, the sole representative of the Florida Marlins. Next up, and we're going to continue. It's going to be the rookie, Rennie Stennett. And Rennie, interestingly enough, hit 353 with his rookie card, and he's hitting 358 in the league, so no reason to snub him. Rennie Stennett just gets over the 100 at-bat threshold. Rennie Stennett will take the middleman spot for the National League, as he can play second base and shortstop. And we will put him at second base temporarily. Doesn't mean he's starting. We're just gonna give him a spot there, replacing Jim Morrison. All right, let's keep going. And we are now punching the clock regularly. It's Tommy Davis. Probably the biggest reason why the Las Vegas team is suddenly interesting this year. Las Vegas is, well, they're in the playoff hunt. They could win that lousy division. And we have Tommy Davis listed as a utility player for Las Vegas. He was on the Dodgers during this period. He was on a bunch of different teams, so that when a guy travels around baseball, that makes him a good candidate for a expansion team. So Tommy Davis as a utility player, we'll have him take Rico Cardi's spot. Congratulations, Tommy Davis. Oops. I didn't do the whole thing here. Sorry about that. Congratulations, Tommy Davis and the Las Vegas Rivieras. Doing better than they did last year. All right, next player on the list. And ladies and gentlemen, Felix Mian, unfortunately, was on the list to make it. But unfortunately, you're going to see later in this segment, he was replaced. Because every team needs a representative. And one of these teams has been played so badly that their lone representative kicked Felix Mian off the team. And I'm sure that's really gotten a Felix's crawl. Felix, we're not putting you on the All-Star team. I'm sorry. It's not your fault. It's the rule where every team needs a representative. Okay. Moving on. George Thomas, not going. Another Arizona snub. Hard to believe. Tony Perez, considered with a 350 average, but we saw just the two home runs, and compared to what, you know, their catcher, Cincinnati's catcher's doing, it didn't seem right. Okay, the next player, Cleon Jones, the heart and soul of the Met offense, is going to the All-Star game. His magical 69 season where he hit 340. Hey, he's hitting 349, so he's overachieving. He is going to the All-Star game for the New York Mets, their first representative. He's got a corner outfield spot, and oddly enough, he will replace Hank Aaron. That's big shoes to fill. Hank's not going. And Cleon Jones is. Congratulations, Cleon Jones and the New York Mets. Next on the list, we're going to skip Phil Gagliano. And finally, we have an Arizona player. So you see Arizona. Don't know exactly why they have one of the worst records in the National League when they have a 382 hitter, a 353 hitter, and a 341 hitter. But Larry Howard gets the nod because he's a catcher. And the National League has only one really good catcher and a bunch of other guys. He will replace Joe Torre's catcher spot. Hint, hint, Joe Torre's no longer a catcher, but you'll find out shortly. So it'll be Larry Howard will take the backup reserve catcher spot for the National League, the lone representative for your Arizona Diamondbacks. Congratulations, Diamondback fans. Stop throwing things at the window. And look who's next on the list. It is Joe Torre. And he, of course, is going to be the representative for the St. Louis Cardinals. And he's their lone representative. And he moves from catcher to your starting third baseman, replacing Larry Parrish. Congratulations, Joe Torre, moving around the diamond. Of course, this is his 1971 card. We'll see this card for two more years and probably two more All-Star games. Congratulations, Joe Torre. Next on the list, and sadly, but not, there's a shining moment here. Roberto Clemente's not going to the All-Star game this year because the Pirates didn't play very well this year, and another Pirate is taking his spot in addition to Rennie Stennett. But the good news is Roberto Clemente will be in the carryover league through 1975, because that's how it works, folks. Eventually, we'll get into the 1972, 73, 74, 75 carryover league, and our friend Roberto Clemente will still be playing baseball. So the tragedy will not happen, and we'll all get to enjoy his performance for a long time. Could you imagine if in that 1975 portion, his final year, if he prevents the Cincinnati Reds from getting to the 1975 World Series? Huh, interesting thought. Okay, sorry, Roberto. We'll see you next year. Dick Dietz, strong catcher, got snubbed. His average is good, but the production's not that great. The next player, and we had Larry Howard, so. The next player is, of course, the heart and soul of the Houston Astros, Colt 45's Cesar Cedeño. Going back to the All-Star game. Cedeño will actually take a utility spot where Claude Washington was last year. Congratulations, Cesar Cedeño and the Houston Astros. All right, next up. And he was an All-Star last year, and he does it again. And this guy played, actually, for the Minnesota Twins during this period, in case you're wondering. Brant Olea. The Twins kind of would have liked to keep him, but, they couldn't keep everybody. Killebrew, Oliva, Carew, you get the idea. So he got exposed, and the Rockies snatched him up, and he has been stellar. Lights out performance. Back-to-back years. So last year, these are his numbers. 314, 10, and 22, and 105 at-bats. I'm going to plug in the new numbers. Same number of at-bats, 12 and 33. Better betting average. Brant Olea, very consistent. For the Colorado Rockies, the brightest spot in what was a dismal season, and the lone Rocky All-Star. It's been a rocky year. All right, next up on the list is the gentleman who has taken Roberto Clemente's spot on the roster, and that is a nice performance for Richie Hebner. I know he's under 100 at-bats, but we really needed a third baseman. We had, Lytle and Singleton at the very top of this video. They're just outfielders. Richie Hebner could play first, third, outfield, and DH. And he was one of the top third basemen in the National League once you get past Joe Torre. So, Richie Hebner will take the utility OF spot that Chet Lemon had last year. Congratulations, Richie Hebner, and the Pirates' second and final representative. Okay, next on the list, Art Shamsky in Las Vegas didn't get there. Ron Hansen, yes, if you watched the All-Star game last year, he played a big part of it, and he's back. And again, he's having a great year for Las Vegas. He was the lone representative last year on a lousy team, but now Las Vegas has two representatives. He joins Tommy Davis. Ron Hansen, he'll be a starting shortstop. And he was the starting shortstop last year. Look at the numbers. 311, 814. And I'm going to plug in the new numbers. He's 327, 518. Ron Hansen, two great years for an expansion team, Las Vegas. Congratulations, Ron. Okay, next on the list, sorry, Mario Martinez and Ralph Garr and Chico Simone and Ken Anderson. Chico Simone, 7 homers and 24 RBIs. That's a shame, but Florida only gets one guy usually. Here we go, folks. You're probably wondering what happened to him. And what happened to him, I'm not going to explain. So Johnny Bench was hitting 364 with 14 homers and 46 RBIs. Then he played seven games against the tough Pittsburgh Pirates, and he did not hit a homer or drive in a run. He stuck. He stuck at 1446, and his average fell to 312. But guess what? He scored the winning run in Game 6 in the game I broadcast, and the Reds beat the Pirates in 7 anyway. So that just goes to show, you know, how versatile and strong this Reds team is and how great Johnny is. Went 46 RBIs. There's nobody close to that. He had 30 last year, 33. You're seeing some of these other guys. Johnny Bench, 46 RBIs in what was 22 games, but he's doing it now in 29 games. 40 hits, 46 RBI for Johnny Bench. Just amazing. So far, the second representative for the Big Red Machine. Okay, we've got one, two, three, about four more hitters to go here before we get to the pitching. And the next guy is on the list, and that is Wes Parker. Having the best offensive year for the Dodgers this year. He was on the All-Star team last year, I believe. Wes Parker, I want to say, yeah, he was the utility guy, corner man. And he'll serve that same role this year. Same role for Wes Parker. Last year was 333, 1-18, no power. But look what happened this year. Same card, but he increased it to 5 homers from 1 a year ago at the All-Star break. So Wes Parker, back-to-back All-Star appearances. Next up, for the National League, Darren Johnson did not make it. But a guy who, for some reason, didn't make it last year, and arguably the best card in the 1969 card set, Willie McCovey is back into the All-Star game where he belongs. With his ridiculous 1969 card, he will be your starting first baseman in the All-Star game. Dick Allen will move to DH, and the DH was Jack Clark. So we'll put, Jack Clark was a Giant, we'll put Willie McCovey at DH presently. You can always move these guys around. We'll put Willie McCovey there. All right, next up on the list, no Ron Hunt or Tony Gonzalez, Matty Alou, Leron Lee, Bill Buckner. These gentlemen are all getting skipped, and we have to go all the way down here. And here's the part two of the Felix Mian story. We started earlier in the video. Glenn Beckert, his 342 card. He's only hitting 295 with it, but the Cubs got to send somebody, and it has been a nightmare season for Glenn Beckert and the Chicago Cubs. He was an All-Star last year at 311. He's an All-Star again. This is his 71 card that hits 342. So maybe he'll help the National League. He wasn't able to help the Cubs much this year. But maybe he'll be able to help the National League win the All-Star game. And I believe we just have one more hitter to announce. And I can find him by scrolling and looking in the home run column. Way down here because the average is kind of low. But the home runs are kind of high. And leading the National League and the Major Leagues in home runs at the All-Star break, Dick Allen from the Phillies, 15 bombs. He was in the All-Star game last year with 13-32 and a 250 average. Plug in his numbers this year, 264, 15-27. Gets you invited back every time. So, Dick Allen and the Phillies have a representative in the All-Star game. Okay, we have named 16 hitters. Bench, Allen, Stennett, Torrey, Hanson, Alea, Tolan, Jones, McCovey, Howard, Parker, Beckert, Mota, Cedeno, Hebner, and Davis. It's time to get to the pitching for the National League. We're gonna page down here to the National League pitching, and here we are. Now, you talked about snubs. We're going to start right off. Wayne Simpson and his $1.38 ERA is not going to the All-Star game because he played for a bad St. Louis team. Gosh, he really, could you imagine if the Reds would have held on to him with everything else Cincinnati has? So Wayne Simpson does not get it. And the reason, the number three starters just don't pitch. They pitch on 4 days rest. And most of the time, your number one and number two guys are pitching on 3 days rest. And I prefer the guys who pitch more innings and perform and get more wins for the All-Star consideration. So sorry, Wayne Simpson. John Matlack also got snubbed, not going for the Mets with a 2.05 ERA. But I think we looked at him down the stretch. He started 3-0 with an ERA of 50 cents. And then he was 1-2 in his last few starts, and that kind of hurt him. So let's start right here with a guy who threw 81 innings, almost as many as Simpson and Matlack had combined. Phil Negro. He will take what was Felix Mian's spot on the for the Braves. And so Felix Mian is off, and Phil Negro is on the All-Star team. He has been the lone bright spot in a very disappointing season for the Braves. So in the rotation, we're going to put Phil Negro in Rick Rodin's spot from a year ago. Congratulations, Phil Negro and the Atlanta Braves. Next up, again, Jerry Johnson was skipped because of the low innings pitched. But the Padres have a young kind of phenom if they could win for him. And that's Dave Roberts, the precursor to Randy Jones. I know he's 4-4, but 71 innings and the 2.27 ERA was too good to pass up. Look at those innings pitch compared to some of these other guys. So Dave Roberts, the lone Padre, and a left-hander. Obviously, he edges out Matlack in consideration as a lefty. He will take Jerry Kuzman's spot in the All-Star game. Dave Roberts, the lone San Diego Padre player. Congratulations, Dave Roberts and the San Diego Padres for not being snubbed. Okay. Next up. Don Sutton's not going. Sorry. But Denny LeMaster. It's funny, but Larry Durker and Denny LeMaster have been alternating All-Star games with their 69 cards in the last four. Both cards were brought in the league in the same time. It's the fourth time using them. It was Durker, LeMaster. Last year it was LeMaster, and he's going to follow it up right here. Last year he was 6-1 with a 2.19 ERA. This year, Denny LeMaster is 5-0 with a 2.48 ERA. Denny LeMaster, the second and final Astro represented in the All-Star game. Congratulations, Denny LeMaster and the Astros. They kind of took a tumble right before the All-Star game. They were in first for most of the first half, but they finished in third. Okay, now we're going to move down to one of the top winners in the National League, anchoring the Dodgers, Messersmith. He started 6-0, finished 7-2 with a 2.83 ERA. Andy Messersmith was probably in the American League representing the All-Star team last year. And so interestingly enough, we have Andy Messersmith traded for Bill Singer, and both guys are taking their new teams to the All-Star game. Singer on the Angels, Messersmith on the Dodgers. He'll take the John Denny spot from a year ago. Congratulations, Andy Messersmith. All right, next on the list, Larry Durker gets snubbed. Well, you have to give Daniel Master his spot. Jerry Kuzman had, 2.88 ERA, but 5-3 is kind of meh. For some reason, only under 60 innings. Here's the guy, Jim Maloney, out of the three spot. So the story of the Reds this year is that they're doing it without much help from Don Gullett, their ace. Don Gullett is 2-5. He's the ace of the Cincinnati Reds, the best team in the National League. He's 2-5. I guess it might be 3-5. We'll see his stats come up as I scroll down this list a little bit. But it's been Jim Maloney with the three spot in the rotation who's been collecting the wins. And that's been the key for the Reds, keeping him above water. We got to give him a roster spot here. And we'll put him in the Craig Leffert spot for the moment. Congratulations, Jim Maloney. And that is number 3 on the Cincinnati list. And we're not done representing the Reds today. Okay. We got, let's see, one more starter and 3 more relievers, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we will be done. The next pitcher, if you scroll down a little bit, we're going to skip some guys here, and we're going right here, last year's Cy Young winner, Juan Marichal. If you win the Cy Young 1 year, and you follow it up with a 6-2 record, I know his ERA is above 3, but so what? It's Juan Marichal. You're not going to hear anybody complain in the National League dugout as he will befuddle American League hitters. So there it was last year. He finished 11-0 in the regular season. He was 8-0 with a .157 at the break. But this year, not quite as good. He's actually pitched more innings. 6-2, 334. Juan Marichal back at it. That is the 6th starter for the National League. You're only going to go with 3 relievers. Okay, 3 more pitchers and we are through with this. Next up, we can just scroll down to the saves to get 3 good relievers here. Oh, I wanted to look for Don Gullett if I can find him. And just see what he is doing. I mean, you see a lot of guys here. Look at Seaver. Seaver's 4-4 with a .448 ERA. That's disappointing. There, and Gullett is right behind him. There it is, folks. Don Gullett, 2-5 with a .450 ERA. He is the ace of the Cincinnati Reds, the only pitcher on the team who can pitch on 3 days rest. So, if he flips the switch and mows everybody down in the second half, it's not much point playing this season, really, at that point. I mean, the Reds are just going to walk away with this thing. All right. Jerry Bell got snubbed. Another Arizona Diamondback. I'm starting to wonder, how did Arizona play so poorly when we saw 3 other hitters hit above .350 and their closer has 7 saves and a .56 ERA. Sorry, Jerry Bell, you got snubbed for the All-Star game. But, and so did Dave Justy of the Pirates because they didn't play that well and he has a .480 ERA. He got snubbed. But, yet again, another Cincinnati Red player, Clay Carroll, a closer. His ERA is nothing, and he has 8 saves. So the 4th and the team with the most representatives, 4 of the 25 players in the National League are going to the All-Star game, and that doesn't include Pete Rose and Tony Perez, which is pretty interesting. But Clay Carroll is an All-Star. And by the way, before you scoff at that, he was in the top 10 in MVP and Cy Young voting in 1972. So, Carroll, we're going to put him in the Camacho spot from a year ago. Congratulations, Clay Carroll. 2 more players for the National League in the bullpen, a lefty and a righty. From the south side of the mound, well, first, we'll get the closer. And the closer, another bright spot for the Portland team, Hoyt Wilhelm. Interestingly, Portland made a nice trade in the offseason, getting Jim Perry, basically for Burt Blyleven. Burt Blyleven is doing great things for the Twins. They also traded for Hoyt Wilhelm from the California Angels, and Hoyt Wilhelm has 7 saves and a .135 ERA. Portland is in first place by half a game in that Mountain Division. He will take another Mountain Division reliever, Ron Reed. He'll take his roster spot. Which leaves us one more player on the list. A lefty reliever for the National League. And when we go to the lefty reliever for the National League, where is he? Ah, here he is. Tug McGraw of the first place New York Mets is going to the All-Star game. We were kind of thinking about Matlack and Kuzman, but when you factored everything in, McGraw as a finisher, and it's 2.38 ERA. It's too good to pass up. And the third and most important lefty on the match, you could say. But I don't know, it's kind of tough. Kuzman and Matlack Summers weren't quite good enough. We wanted to get another Mets pitcher on the game, so we got Tub McGraw. He gets to go. He struggled in one loss, but then he rebounded pretty well down the stretch. So that's it for the teams. We got the cumulative numbers right here. You see the National League has a little few more bats. 329 for the American League, 335 for the National League. The home runs are close. It's pretty close, really. All the stats are pretty close for the hitting. And as far as pitching, the American League decided to go with an extra reliever. So that's why there's a disparity in the innings. National League is 36 wins. American League is 26 saves. American League team ERA is 207, which is a half a run better than the National League's 253. So that's it today for the All-Star Game Selection Show. The game will be played and broadcasted this Thursday, July the 15th. Hope you can tune in, and thanks for checking it all out.